Hello and welcome back to Let's Build. This is where we got to last time. And now we're going to start by placing these little things on the side here, giving the building much more depth. And as we can look at the original image, you can see that it has these little bits on the corners. So this is what I've tried to replicate here with covers, cover strips and panel strips. And you can also see what I've just done in the top there by the roofing is I've added these little kind of details which really goes with the style of the original house if we look at the original Lego build. And that's just something which kind of makes it really spooky and also very old looking, as it's quite an old fashioned design. And as we go round here, we can see that I'm adding it to all the sides. And I also had the rear windows, which I also added all the framing and everything for. So now we're just going around and we're adding all these little cover strips and panel square corner blocks, just so you can see that little design there by the roofing. We do have a little glitch on the bottom right there. I'm not sure why that's actually happening, as I've never actually seen that before. But that's just one of the problems with Tekkit, well, with Redpower and the microblocks. And now we can see that on the roof, I've added a little wood strip around the edge. And now I'm adding little cover strips. And these are going all the way around. And these are to add the little spikes, which you can see in the original image, which go around the top. And then I have these little panel corner blocks, which have been placed on top, just to give it more kind of, make it less flat. Give it more depth. Give it more exciting stuff to actually look at. Just to make it more realistic and something that you really could not find in a normal Minecraft build. And this is what sets Tekkit builds apart, is the fact that you can have all these sort of things with Redpower microblocks, and it just gives so much more depth and interesting stuff to the build. So now I'm starting work on the little tower here, and I'm starting to build this up, and I'm figuring out how this is going to look from the ground. So as we can see, I just moved the window up one, replacing in the windows. And we're just going around and adding the same sort of design features that were added into the house. So we have these things around the corner. And then I'm also going to start decorating the windows. And you can see kind of in more depth here what's actually being added to the windows to give that design. And there we go. I've also added it on the window at the back there, so that there's a window on both sides of the tower. And as you can see right at the top of the video, you can actually see, there we go, we have the start of the roofing just out of shot there. I didn't realize it was out of shot when we was filming. And then we've also got that same design with the little parts that go just below the roof, just to make it more kind of period, more periodic, more period featured, you know, something makes it very old and spooky about that sort of design. And there we go, we have this wide shot just showing you everything. And that actually has most of the house pretty much done. I'm just now finishing the top of that little tower roof there. And also we're going to be adding little wood parts to the top. And then we're going to be adding those spikes again. Just so we have the little spike design on that roof as well. So we have it on both the main part of the roof and the tower part of the roof, which is just, again, out of video. Now I'm adding more features to this roofing, just as I did with the original roof. I'm adding the little corner blocks and the strip blocks, just so we have the more kind of rounded and different kind of shape to the roof, which you definitely would not be able to make with vanilla Minecraft. And now you can see I'm making this little window that's coming out of the roof here, just right at the front of the building. And as you can see, I'm now building the wood out and I'm placing in the window, just so we have that kind of cool design. As you can see a bit closer there, I'm now working it, and it's also going to be going to have a little shape to the roof, which will be added. I'm just adding in thicker blocks there, just so we have more depth. And then I'm going to be adding in some sort of strip blocks into the middle. And there we go, you can see that we have that sort of round shape to the top of the window. And I'm just adding the frames again to get the same sort of design, and just so it's all matching with the rest of the house. So there we go, just starting work on the roof, and now you can see the spikes just like they were on the other part of the roofing, where we're going to be adding different strip covers and also corner blocks, so we have that different sort of shape. So now to finish off the build, I'm now ending it with a little wind compass to add at the top of the tower. And that's a nice little spooky feature, as if you've ever watched a little haunted film, you would have heard the squeaking of a wind compass in the wind. So I wanted to add something cool to the top. Now, it's very difficult to make a chicken shape, so I made it very simple. And even from just looking at it, you should know, really, that it is a wood compass. So now that is actually the house built. So now what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be building a little frame, a little wall around the edge, where we're going to encase the house with a little spooky garden. So there we go, I'm just building the wall around, and we're adding posts, and then we're adding little iron fences, just so we have a nice little spooky and kind of, it's kind of very homely, but spooky at the same time design. And there we go, I didn't anticipate with the camera there, so it moves a bit, but there we go. And as a very subtle addition, I also added little cover blocks, to the top of these little posts here, just so it's slightly taller than the fence. It's a tiny little design, but it's really effective, and I really like to do walls this way. As if anyone does notice, they should appreciate it. Now, what I'm doing here is I'm building, I'm placing dirt, but this isn't just dirt, because obviously grass will grow back on dirt. So I'm using any sort of dirt micropanel, so in this case I'm just placing in slabs, and then I'm just digging random holes in the garden, and then I'm placing dirt slabs, and this means that the dirt will not turn into grass, and it will forever stay as dirt. So if you wanted to make a dirt trail on side of grass, all you actually need to do is just make the holes, and then place in some slabs on the top half of the hole, and that creates the effect of dead grass in the garden. So now I'm building a little crypt entrance. It's just a kind of interesting thing to add into the garden, but it also makes it very spooky, as obviously a crypt entrance is not the sort of thing you would find in any normal garden. So again, I'm using different types of dirt blocks to kind of make patchy dirt and steps down into there, and I'm just using some nice stone brick panels and slabs just so we get a nice little crypt entrance. So now I'm making the graves and the grave spots. Now I'm just using the grave spots with dirt, and then I'm using different types of, we've got cobble and mossy cobble, just so we have different types of graves in the little graveyard. So they're not all the same, and some of them are mossy. And then again, I go back and I add some mossy brick to the crypt entrance, just so it adds more depth and more spookiness to it all. To finish it all off, I use different types of dirt blocks to make different holes with the graveyard, and then I use some bone meal, and I placed it down all around in the garden, then I took out the flowers. So here we have the final finished piece. There we go, we've got our little graveyard here. And then we're panning up and you can see the entire house. Now I've actually used some yellow light blocks and powered them from the inside, so there's no actual interior. But I think it actually looks better like this. So we have all the way around all these lit up yellow blocks just on the insides of the windows. So that is it for this little let's build. That was only two parts. I want to make more of these, so if you've enjoyed this, please let me know by rating, commenting, and subscribing. I'd love to make more of these because, as you guys know, if any of you have seen my tech it build videos, I don't actually give map downloads, and that's because I build these on a server and it's not really that easy, and also because it's very difficult to get schematics. It also means that if I was trying to make one build and put it into a schematic, MC Edit doesn't really deal with schematics that well that have Tekkit blocks in them. So it's very difficult indeed to actually try and, you know, to prune out something from a map, even though I don't actually have this map. But if I were to, it's still very difficult indeed. So thank you for watching. If you want to check me out on Facebook and Twitter, you can find a link in the description below. If you want to see this build more up close and personal, I will put some extra pictures in the description below. But until next time, thank you for watching, and goodbye.